except foot. Maybe it was okay to begin with. I think I'm gonna give this girl a hammer. Can't help it. It's what I use all the time, so... maybe the hammer will... this will be the hammer for now. Shoulders look a little wide. Gonna fix that. Hands look a little long. Fix that. I'll fix it as best as I can. Also, guys, if the sound quality is, like, off, or if I'm like the music's too loud, let me know. This is like a test stream. I haven't like streamed in like a while, so I might have to like fix all my settings again. Let's see how that goes. Yeah, what's with the shoulder? Go this way. Go this way. Okay, cool. All right. Also, I'm sorry, I'm just like talking to myself. I'm like super like nervous when I do this stuff, so if I start babbling, tell me to shut up, and that'll be no problem. A little tilting. Maybe I'll give her the bone hammer, just like match it all off. This a little smaller. Okay. Actually, this armor, like this Blade Master one, she has like big old ears. Almost like bunny ears. It's kind of cute considering that it's all like, you know, bones and stuff. Give her a little slightly poopy hair. Guess I'll bring this up. Start putting clothes on her so I don't get banned. Gonna make her taller though. Taller in the waist. If you have like a short waist but like long legs, your character is still gonna look like short. I don't know. Or they're just gonna look like weird. Unless you're like going for Bayonetta. Although she's got a tall torso too, so. Also guys, sorry, I don't have like a camera with a mic yet, and I only have like 2 USB jacks, so camera's coming soon. Either I get a different mic or I find a camera that has a microphone already on it, and then I don't have to use up so much of my USB ports. Did I say USB jack? What the hell? No such thing. Currently drawing Monster Hunter because Generations came out. It's one of my favorite games. Embarrassingly, I'm using the bone armor set, even though I'm high rank. I've been going around doing key quests as much as I can. I just haven't gotten around to making, like, a decent, like, armor. But, I don't know. Bone armor's like a classic, right? Plus it has the knockout ability, so... I use hammers all the time. It helps. I believe so. Also, apologize for the music. I listen to mainly Japanese stuff. Don't understand it. I just super like anime. A lot of game soundtracks have, at least the games I play have, Japanese soundtracks. You know, the bone armor is really basic. I love the shapes about it. I like organic stuff. Like, I thought about drawing the Rathalos armor later if, like, the stream's keeping up okay. I got, like, a new, like, high-speed internet. I used to stream, but it was always, like, a fucking mess because I had embarrassingly slow internet and it would just disconnect at the drop of a hat. So, it's not good for when you're drawing to be constantly having to deal with computer issues. Hope this goes a little better. This arm's looking too short. When you're like sketching in digital, it's kind of cool to like, if there's something wrong, you can just easily move stuff. Hey, Danger! It has been a while. It has been a very long while. I apologize. But I don't know if you heard me, but I got like new internet stuff, so it seems to be going okay. I've been able to watch other people's streams, and that's a good indication, because before it was just like I couldn't even watch people's streams before. My computer would just like have a heart attack and just nope. So we're seeing how this goes. Yeah, my old internet was like allergic to OBS, so with this new and improved one, seems to be going okay. Again, I hate jinxing myself, but I don't know. How's it going, man? What are you up to? What games are you playing? I'm gonna have a camera again soon. It's just right now I needed to choose between the mic or the cam. I only have so many USB ports in my Cintiq, so yeah. I'm hoping to get an actual PC soon. It's been a while since I've like used a PC. Is there a tail on this thing? To kind of go with the bunny thing? Maybe. Let's just do it anyways. Let's see if anyone says anything. Oh, you're playing Monster Hunter while I draw? That's cool. I should have Monster Hunter music playing. Well, this song's kind of like the Nargacuga song. I don't know if you heard it earlier. There it goes. What Hunter rank are you? If I had one of those like one of those capture cards for the DS, I would just be streaming Monster Hunter nonstop. I would be streaming Monster Hunter between 2 and 4 a.m. That's the only time I get to play it. You're only Hunter rank 7, you're like 200 ranks above me. It's been really difficult to not just binge play that game. I need to set aside a weekend to just binge play Monster Hunter. I feel incomplete. You know when you get a new game and it's just like, I don't have time to play it. It's just eating away at you, and then like one weekend when you got a lot of stuff to do, you're like, you know what? I can't do it. This has got to be done. And then you just waste the whole weekend on your couch or on your bed, whatever, whatever you feel like playing. Just binge play a game. Those are like the best weekends of my life. Give her a bone hammer, I guess. I forgot what the bone hammer looks like. It's kind of like this, right? It's kind of something. Yeah, Monster Hunter is like a... Because of the way you play Monster Hunter 2, it's like a huge addiction for me. Like, it's so easy to just like, oh, I could just go like a mission. I'll just do one mission. It's like, oh, sweet. Well, I'm just like 2 items away from making an armor. All right, I'm just going to finish this armor. Oh, wait, it's like... In the meantime, now I've gathered enough stuff to make, like, the weapon to match it. Let me just do the weapon. And then, you know, it's 2 hours have gone by, and you are so behind on everything you need to do. So that's why I've only been playing Monster Hunter, like, at 2 a.m. Like, I'm like, alright, I'm absolutely done. There's nothing I could draw at this point that's going to be good quality. I'm too tired. I'm just gonna play Monster Hunter. Although lately, my friends and family have noticed that I'm looking pretty tired lately, so I'm starting to get bags under my eyes for hunting so late. I'm liking this Monster Hunter, though. It's not as story-heavy as the previous one, which is fine. Fine by me. I almost kind of miss the cinematics, though. I swear to God, I'm not at the last tier of all the village quests, and I haven't even gotten any, like, more, like, movies or anything, and, like, the last Monster Hunter, you got a movie for every fucking quest you did, almost. I guess they're just like, yeah, these people know these monsters. There's nothing to do here. I actually really like how this one doesn't hold your hand. It's just like, alright, go get the monster. It kind of reminds me of, like, the older Monster Hunter stuff, you know? I'm glad they kept the climbing mechanics from the previous Monster Hunter though. Fix that jaw. Feels weird to be drawing stuff like this. I've been drawing mostly sci-fi stuff lately. Feels good though. I always prefer drawing organic stuff anyways. Aw, thanks for the host, Mr. Creep. I'm not worthy of your host stuff yet. This is a test again. Yet again. But it seems to be going a lot better than the last times, you know? Now I'm just inviting bad luck by saying that, but, you know. Hey neighbor, yeah that's right! You guys, moving all your stuff, today? No, it's gotta be tomorrow. If you're moving stuff today, there's no way you could be fucking on Twitch. Maybe you can, I don't know. You're like a Twitch god. So excited for you guys! When I saw like that tweet from like, I think I saw the tweet at the same time from like Wander and Grim about the big move, I was like, holy shit. Those son of a bitch, they did it. They did it behind my back. No, I'm kidding. That's so cool though. I never imagined that you guys would go out of LA. You loading up the cars right now? Have fun! I don't know if you guys have anything heavy to move. I guess just your PCs and desks and beds, but yeah, other than that, if you gotta move a fridge or anything, don't envy that. Diamond Bar is a nice place, though. I've never personally lived in it, but it's super close to where Din Money lives, so yeah. What, you need my help moving stuff? I'm sort of strong. I've been going to the gym, so I think I can lift like 10 pounds now. It looks like he's gonna die. It doesn't surprise me. I thought his gymnasium techniques would help gymnastics. Do you guys like have to like get a fridge there and stuff too? It kind of looked like your kitchen was like super empty. Cause I'm like in the middle of like apartment hunting and stuff too, and I'm noticing the big difference between do I want a place that comes with all the appliances and ready to go, or not? Cause it's a lot cheaper to move in now, but then I have to buy a fridge later. And I'll probably be living with a mini fridge for like 2 years before I get a regular fridge. Well, I can't wait for the housewarming party. I know you guys are gonna be exhausted, but whenever you could get that in order, just, you know, throw up the window and just yell out, I'll hear ya. I'll come right over. I'll bring refreshments. Bring in the fridge. Whew. Have fun lifting that. Have Brett do it. Brett knows how to lift fridges. Now we gotta catch your stream too lately. I know I caught like Brett's. I tried to catch Wander's one night, but I just wasn't home in time. But I've been trying to catch up on everybody again. Because I've been gone for so long. Actually, let me save this really quick. Bone. Sorry, you have to see my shitty pop-up thing. Bone armor, 01A. Here we go. See, I can believe Andy can lift it. Watching all that wrestling's paid off. think I pass through Diamond Bar every time I go to LA because I take the 60 or something. I don't know. I lived in California almost all my life and I have no idea where anything is really. Alright, I think I'm gonna start detailing this a bit, I guess. Give it a shot. Hey, Mikey Maru, how's it going? I'm back. Sort of. My camera isn't. I need to figure out a situation for my camera, but I'm drawing. Woo! Yay! What a good day it is. But you guys have no idea how embarrassing it is. Like how many times I've tried to like stream. I'm like, I give up. And then my brother's just like, you just gotta get better internet. I'm like, that's it? Everything else? Okay. Because I've been trying a lot of stupid shit on my computer. I'm not computer savvy at all. I'm quite the old lady when it comes to that. To the Draper remix. This Porter Robinson song? Porter Robinson is really nice. I have a couple of his CDs. I actually got introduced to him because he made the song with the Vocaloid. I'm like a super nerd for Vocaloid stuff, so I'm like, oh, I'll just automatically like it. But then I got hooked on to listening to his other stuff, so I'm like, oh, this is super chill. The older I get, the more chill my music tastes become. Although I still have some hyper J-pop bullshit laying around. We'll probably come across it soon. I'm not sorry. Oh, you miss my streams? That's super nice of you, Mikey. I super miss streaming too, actually. Because even though I'm nervous about drawing, there's something really cool about drawing Monster Hunter. Or any fan art, really, in front of people. Or any piece of art, I guess. It's just that mostly people are more interested in like stuff they know, like fan art. It's fine. I have no problem with that. Move her eyeball up. Oh, I like the song Flicker too. I like, Is Flicker that one song where it's that one Japanese girl that they just keep remixing that one sentence she says? That's a good one. I have like that and like a remix that we're probably gonna come across it. Let me put this one far down, yeah. Yeah, Porter Robinson is like super chill to listen to. Oh, better get rid of that yay, it makes no sense backwards. Yeah, he has really nice stuff. I'm trying to find more stuff like that, you know? I'm so old, I kept calling this stuff techno for the longest time. And then I find out it's called, like, EDM trance. Although this one isn't really electronic dance music, but you know, trance and like, house. What is that? House is when it's all minimal. This is really showing my age. I just listen to what I like. How have you guys been doing though, Mikey Maru? I know I already asked Danger. I saw some of your artwork on Twitter recently, Mikey. I thought I was following you before, but I guess I wasn't, so I started following you. Yeah, cool stuff. I liked your Naruto piece. It's got a fun energy to it. And there is something so therapeutic about drawing Monster Hunter armor. There's just so many like details and layers to everything. And then after a while, you're like, I'm not even trying to be accurate anymore. I'm just trying to pack as much crap as I think it has on there, you know? It's like when people like are like not really into like drawing, but they love rendering, you know? That's what it feels like to me when I draw like armor stuff like this, you know? Once you lay down the framework of the human body and whatever, you know. I mean, we started off with this pretty much, this basic bitch. Then we turned her into this. I'm compiling a playlist for Twitch. And I'm trying to fill it with music that I think is non-abrasive and just totally chillax. So this is gonna be a lot of Porter Robinson and Porter Robinson remakes. Hopefully not back to back. Do I like the new Monster Hunter game? Nah. Nah, I fucking love it, man. It's great. I was like wondering, like, because I was thinking, it's just like, I wonder if they're gonna keep the climbing mechanics of Monster Hunter 4 Ultimate. Because they didn't keep Tri's swimming mechanics. And I was like, maybe that's just gonna be every game's gonna have its one travel power. You know, one is swimming, one is climbing. Maybe this will be flying, because I kept seeing blimps and the aerial, you know, style. And I'm like, oh no, they kept the climbing. You know, like, that's cool. I like that. I really do like this new Monster Hunter game. Mainly because I get to visit Poke Village and Yukumo Village. From. That takes me back way when. Like, I was so excited when Yukumo came about, because that was only for, like, the PSP, you know? Monster Hunter Portable 3rd. And I loved it. I don't know, because I'm like a big, you know, weeb. I'm like, it's like Japan! I loved it. Like, all the hot springs stuff and, like, the samurai starter set, pretty much. So, sorry if I spoiled it for you, Mikey. But you travel in that game. And one of the places you travel is that. And but Poke Village, I actually get so sentimental when I hear the music from that village, you know? Let me fix up her hands now. I mean, I spent too much of my youth playing Monster Hunter. Not that I'm complaining. It's just a lot of memories were made in that town, and I feel like such a schmuck getting all sentimental about, you know, a video game like Monster Hunter, but, you know, to me it's just as beautiful as a game like Ico or something. Like, the attention to, like, all the details, like, in the animations, in the hunters and the monsters themselves, it's great. I like how backgrounds can tell a story. Like, every time I walk into a map, I'm like, alright. You can walk around and then you come across an old camp. Not one that you can rest at, but one that was all torn up and stuff. And it's just like, ooh, that sucks for whoever lived there. Uh-oh. Don't know that number. I don't know. I like looking at monsters and like seeing how like they break apart. For some reason, that always interests me. It's like, I wonder what's gonna break apart. Like, when I come across a new monster, like, does the head break? Does the tail even come off? And if not, I wonder why. Sometimes there's a good reason why the tail never comes off and all you can do is break it or whatever. And I don't know why, that stuff fascinates me. I like animals, I like going to the zoo. Maybe that's why. Seen people stream it? Yeah. You've been drawing a lot more than ever now, Mikey? That's great. I'm actually getting into drawing a lot more into personal stuff lately. I've been getting a lot of commission and project stuff out of the way. So right now I'm getting some more free time, so I'm starting to just draw what I want. So yeah. Dude, I love redesigns to armors. To me, it's like pretty much a whole new armor set when they do that. I love it. Do it to all of them. It's fine. I'm like the Rathalos armor, it's great. Could, you know, give it a new hat. Even if it's just a new fucking hat, I get so happy. It's practically like, I don't know. I have this one friend who, because when I was playing Overwatch, I was playing that for a while. I still kind of am. Actually, I still am. I just have to find time to get into it again. That's just this thing. When I have a video game, I can't play multiple video games at once. It's like I devote all my attention to one game at a time. I'm not some cheater. I don't go playing a bunch of games at once like some... No, I'm just kidding. If you guys do that, that's fine. I wish I had the time to play a bunch of games at once, but one at a time for me. You know what? I think she's pretty good for a sketch. Maybe I should see what the bone hammer actually looks like. I never use the bone hammer, but I use the bone armor a lot. It's so weird. Actually, I guess it's not that weird. But like I said, this particular bone armor S has the KO ability. And that's cool to have it right away, so... You know what, I'm not even gonna draw that hammer. Okay, I'm gonna try drawing that hammer. But for this hammer to work, I think I have to make her hands... kinda like this. Kinda up a bit. Alright. Fuck this bone hammer. I'm gonna draw a different bone hammer. I'm kind of like referencing the hammer off the... this is all drawn from reference. I don't want anyone to think I have this good of a photographic memory. If I ever like draw without reference, you can tell. I'll say so. I'll put a, hey look, this is a memory game edition. I gotta remember what this armor looks like, so... Aren't you impressed? I like drawing stuff from memory too. Usually I do that when I'm like out and about. It's like, I really feel like drawing the Kieran armor. Can't remember what it looks like. I'll just make it up and get something close to it, you know? I haven't been caught yet. Working on personal stuff is a great feeling for any artist, you know? Working on, like, you know, working for money is lovely. But sometimes you just gotta, like, draw something for yourself. Arms are looking kind of short. Now they're looking kind of long. This arm's looking short. That looks a little better to me. Yeah, the planning and designs of Monster Hunter is crazy. I do agree. Like, everything from the way the monster moves to what it, like, eats when it's hungry. Like, I love that. I have a little cactus patch set aside just for the Diablo and Minoplos. So, I don't know, does anything else eat that cactus patch? Is Nibblesnarf? No, Nibblesnarf eats meat. He's not a plant eater. I don't know all the monsters that are coming back in this game. So, I wonder if I'm gonna see... you know, sometimes I forget the English names. What was the name of the Doborebeku? What was the name of that Minotaur guy from, you know, he has the big ol', he's like a giant cow. He eats wood and he spins around and he's really big. Alright, cut into that foot there. Move this hand here. All this surgery for the sketch phase. I try not to redraw as much as I can till it's... I absolutely have to. I only play one or two games at a time, pretty slow finishing games because, yeah, same here. There used to be a rush to finish things, but Metal Gear Solid, like, 5, for example, I haven't beat it yet, but I'm fine with that. It took me, like, 2 years to just beat Peace Walker, but I wasn't in a rush to beat it. I was just taking my time playing a mission wherever I wanted, trying to just finish stuff before I finished the actual game. So, I'm done with that. Is there any kind of armor I should draw after this? This is like a test stream, so I don't really have anything super planned. I mean, I was gonna draw the I keep calling this thing the Popo Drum, the Gammoth armor, because that's the newest armor that I made from the new monsters that I loved. Sorry, I have to answer a text. Someone's like, "Come to Disneyland, it's like empty right now." And I'm like, "Yeah, I'll bet." It's like the middle of like a Tuesday when school's back in session. I don't think I can go today. I have like an annual pass, that's the only reason why I get hit up to go there whenever. I don't gotta pay. They have the Rathalos, Silver Rathalos, and the Dread King Rathalos. What? Dread Queen? What is that? Are they like made of shadows or something? Durambaros, yeah, that's him. Durambaros is his name. Sorry, I'm like looking at the chat right now. But yeah, if you guys have like an armor request, say it and I might do it. I will say this. If you could try to not request a crazy armor from Monster Hunter Generations yet, I'm only Hunter rank like 4, so I don't know what's out there. Like if you guys go, "Yeah, do the Yamasukami armor from Monster Hunter Generations," I'll be like, "Well, holy shit, he's back? Nobody told me." And I just kind of don't want to look it up and spoil myself, so yeah. Oh, you fight him in Hunter ranks 6? All right. Well, I guess I'll see him soon. I like him. I like any monster that needs the hammer, so. Let's see. How did this hammer go? I'll just make this part up. Also, I'm still working on my Twitch alerts, so. Sorry. I'm still unprepared. I've been waiting to make a comeback, and I still have much to do. Also, when you're sketching, to me, I just try to stick to one brush. If you notice, I kind of like select a bunch of stuff and then I'll just increase the size of the brush and just, do something like that. Sorry, that didn't really explain anything. The deviant forms of Wraithian and Rathalos with an all-new set. Also, yeah, don't do those. I want to surprise myself. Monster Hunter is the only thing I have going on lately. I'm one of those people that I'm like, "Sure, spoil it, I don't give a shit," but when I actually do care about the movie or video game or whatever, I'm like, I don't like to see anything. I don't even like to see trailers. Like, I remember when they were just like, "Yeah, like, you want to see the new trailer release right before the movie comes out?" It always shows the fucking plot and everything. I don't know, I hate it. Anyways, sorry about that. I just saw Suicide Squad, and I liked it. Thought it was cool. Every time a movie tries to advertise it has good scores on Rotten Tomatoes, I get so pissed. I get so dismissive. I'm like, Jesus Christ. But it turned out to be, I don't know, I wasn't expecting a lot from it anyways, so. Whatever. I was just happy to see Katana. Katana do her thing. I'm not a huge Harley Quinn fan. Well, I kind of am. I used to be super into her, but I'm more of a Poison Ivy fan. If they ever do Poison Ivy, great. That'll be cool. I'm not holding my breath, though. I feel like Uma Thurman was the only shot we had at that, and we fucked it up. Dread King and the Dread Queen. That just sounds so cool. I mean, gold and silver, Rathalos and Wraithian. Rathalos, Rathion. I know people pronounce them differently. Sorry if my pronunciation of monsters is making anybody angry out there. I'm trying to think of cool armor. Do you want an armor from Generations? Yeah, I mean, I haven't made the Glavinus armor yet. I haven't made the Astalos armor yet. Actually, it could just be any monster hunter armor, to be honest. It doesn't have to be Generations. I'm just saying, if you're requesting one from Generations, just, you know, don't request the end boss, you know. Like, don't request, like... like the Fatalis kind of armor, you know, like something like that, you know? It's just like... because if I gotta look up the armor, it's gonna show me the monster. Have some titty on a rookie hunter in Monster Hunter Generations. And if anybody saw Suicide Squad, did you like it? Did you hate it? I can understand if you didn't like it. I use one brush to sketch. That's cool. See, I used to use a ton of brushes to sketch, but that's when, like, you're kind of going for a mix of, like, sketching and painting, I think. Which is still good. Especially if you have to just, like, sketch out cities and structures, you know, really quickly. But when it comes to, like, drawing a person, like, I just stick to one brush. Yeah. Yeah, you did it. Getting rid of her. Gonna flip her, see if there's anything I can add. So I can like pad up her hand a bit more. Cool. Well, I guess she's done. I'm just gonna put a silhouette on her so she'll be easy to see when I cast her to the side. I'm done with her. Suddenly see Suicide Squad? It's cool. I mean, I guess it did- this is the best a movie's done in August this year. Or like, it's like, despite its negative reviews, you know, people still wanted to see it, which is cool. It's doing pretty well, so I don't think they're gonna yank it anytime soon. I will say the music wasn't really my super fave of that movie, but that's just music. That's a personal taste. If you're a huge Joker fan, this might, I don't know. I'm not a super big Joker fan, so I was alright with the way they portrayed him. But I know some people were like, Joker would never do that. It's like, maybe. Playing too soon? Eh, I thought it was cool. I thought it was fun. Alright, don't know what armor to draw next, so I'm just gonna draw generic posy lady until I get something going. In the meantime, just gonna put it right there. Should I darken her a bit?